What's up, y'all? I am Marcus, also known as EMB, and welcome back to From the Dark, a holistic Dark Souls Let's Play. Today, I talked last time about maybe going after gargoyles today, but I think we're going to do things in a little bit different order, because I want to get some kind of unusual dialogues that people might not get very often. Somebody just kindled the bonfire that I last rested at. That's why I now have 11 Estus Flasks, 12 Estus Flasks. That's what that flash above my head was actually all about, too. That's something that you're only going to encounter when you're playing online. So it may be something that players maybe haven't seen before. We are in human form here. We may get invaded, and getting invaded here often means just death, because invaders tend to have some pretty good stuff, just wanting to gank low-level players around this area. The chapel and the burg tend to be dangerous spots. It's all good. Even if we die, we're not going to worry too much about it. One thing I want to talk about, though, the old church over here, and that was abandoned in favor of the new church here. My friend mireneye, long-time community member mireneye, actually reminded me, he pointed out that there was a map for Dark Souls 1. I think it was with the limited versions of the games. I have the original Japanese version of it that just came with the normal game in Japan. But it actually labels that as the Old Forest and the Church, and then this one is separately labeled as the Undead Church, which is kind of interesting from a lore perspective. Like, we have one church maybe specifically dedicated to, or used by, the undead, and another one that in the forest. So, and maybe there was a settlement in the forest. Well, we know there was some sort of settlement in the forest before, but maybe that church was... I hate it when he sees me and he does that little dance. Come on now. This would be a great place for the Drake Sword. That dance buffs these guys, and you saw how much damage that Dregling just did to me in one hit. I called him a Dregling. That Hollow did to me in one hit there. Dregling is a term from Demon Souls, and I still accidentally call them that every once in a while. This would be a horrible time to get invaded, by the way, while dealing with all this nonsense. Oopsie. Ugh. Use my extra Estus flasks up there. Good God. Oh. Alright. Is that it? Is that all of them? I just want to get the Channeler dead, because the Channeler is not going to respawn. The Channeler also had... Oh, you fucking troll down there with the Baldur Knights. Classic. This is classic Dark Souls right here. Actually, that doesn't happen particularly often, but it's happened to me on a few different playthroughs now where the Channeler falls down here. Hopefully I can lure him away from those Baldur Knights, because they're already bad enough as it is. Dealing with them while they're buffed up, really nasty. There we go. Alright. Oh, no, Channeler tried it. Not this time. Not this time. And yes, I skipped that. I skipped that for a reason. I'm going to talk about it in just a little bit. I'm going to talk about it. Completely forgot. Completely lost my train of thought. Thanks for these troll ass... the Channeler and these bros here. Oh well. Can we see from here? We can see the broken walkway out there. And can we get a peek at the old church in the forest? Maybe just a little bit of it. Not really. Alright, well, I tried. I always like to try to see what we can see from the different vistas, because you really never know what you're going to get to see. I think I'm missing some sound effects, and I'm starting to remember, I think there was a bug on the PC version where some of the audio effects don't play properly, and I think we're actually encountering that bug. Yeah, let me get some humanity here. This... that one you can break through. That one's sealed tight. Alright, up here. Meet a very conniving character.
Oh, still human, are you? Then I am in luck. Could you help me? As you can see, I am stuck without recourse.
Press that button.
Please, I have duties to fulfill, and I will reward you handsomely. Well, I am certain you stand to benefit.
Duties to fulfill.
Please.
Alright. This is what the mystery key is for. You can also open this door with the master key if you start use that as the starting gift, or if you start with the thief class.
Thank you. Yes, sincerely. I am Knight Lautrec of Karim. I truly appreciate this, and I guarantee a reward only later. Yes, very sorry. Your reward will have to wait. I've just been freed. Allow me some time.
Even on my very first playthrough, I immediately assumed that guy was up to no good because I'd played Demon Souls. And if you played Demon Souls, then you know about Yurt the Silent Chief. And Lautrec the Embraced is very, very similar in design to Yurt the Silent Chief. Now, this is the way forward to the gargoyles. We're not going to go there today. We're going to skip that for now because we can get some kind of unique dialogues if we go a different route. People kindling that bonfire. Candle that bonfire. Give me that Estus back. Down here, I talked a little bit about a long-time community member, mireneye, that reminded me about the map. I want to talk about another community member that's been doing some really good stuff recently named illusorywall. Here, we're going to find ourselves a Firekeeper soul. And this is actually a female corpse. You can tell from the kind of strips of bra that exist there across the chest. This corpse type is not used... It's only used in a few specific locations through the game. The Firekeeper soul is a very... Normally with Firekeeper souls, because each Firekeeper is a corporeal manifestation of her bonfire and a draw for the humanity which is offered to her. Her soul is gnawed by infinite humanity and can boost the power of precious Estus flasks. The Firekeepers are women. They're all women, and so it really makes sense that all of these corpses that have these souls will be women. But it's some analysis. There's one other place, I think, where there's a female corpse that illusorywall found, and we'll talk about it when we get there. But I really suggest following illusorywall on Twitter. I will put a link in the description to that. And it's really something to me because illusory has done some other stuff, like... I created a screenshot gallery of all of the places where vagrants can spawn. It's very useful, and as talking about doing some other original research, like the poise damage or super armor damage done by each of the different attacks of each of the weapons. Like, this is somebody who's doing lots of research on stuff that's interesting to me, and I think it's interesting because right now there is a lot of, how can I say this? There's a lot of controversy and a lot of cynicism in the Souls community, and people are saying they don't even want to be part of the Souls community anymore. But I just want to kind of remind people that there are lots of really good people too. there are guys like Mireneye, who's been around like forever. There's guys like Illusory, who is someone that I only fairly recently, like within the past few months, have known about myself, that's still doing interesting things with the Souls games. Like, this is a sort of research that I always used to do back before I had any sort of official affiliation with FromSoft, where, like, researching stamina regeneration and those sorts of mechanics. There he is. Or she. New Hellkite was gonna show up. But yeah, I mean, it's just one of those things. There are plenty of really good people who are doing lots of really interesting things in the community. And the community is so full of people with so many, with such a wide range of interests and skills. I mean, you've got people like... Am I about to get burned? Yep. Oh, that was an instant death. Oh, shit. I was not really actually expecting that to take off as much damage as it did. Damn it, so much for my shortcut. Let's try to sneak that. I know you can do this. I just don't remember how. It's been a while. Like, we could, of course, go back to Firelink Shrine and do that whole... I forgot to unlock the elevator shortcut at the church. Ooh, shit. Shit, shit, shit. That's what I... Oh, there's my souls. Too busy talking about the community, because it's just, it's something that's come up a lot recently. Maybe we just bait you down and then, actually, you know what, no, we're gonna go back to the church and we're gonna get the elevator shortcut to Firelink and we'll just go that route. But yeah, like, and there's so many great artists in the Souls community as well. There of course, Carson, my friend Dan Kim, Clone Manga, who's got some great soul sketches and strips and stuff. Like, there's just so many great people in the community that it's kind of depressing to me to see people having it ruined by this controversy or this person or that person or just whatever. And I say this as a person who, through the years, I've had my moments where I wanted to just be done with things as well myself, honestly. There's been, like, no less than death threats and all kinds of other ridiculous nonsense that has gone on, but, you know, in the end, I've met so many awesome people through these games that it's not worth it to me to give up being a part of the community. Like, even if I can't post in the same sorts of forums that I used to post in, I still consider myself to be a member of the community. Like, it's kind of proud of it, to be honest. So there's that. I just had to comment on it, and seeing things like new research coming out from guys like illusorywall and having OGs like Mira and I post, it just kind of really reminded me, like, this community is not as bad. You can't judge an entire community based off of the lowest common denominator. You can't. It just doesn't work that way.
How did that silly sorcerer's apprentice end up? You know, the one always prattling on about Master Logan. He left for the undead burg, but never came back. Serves him right. If even old Big Hat can't make it out there, what chance does he have? I hope he enjoys his new life as a hollow.
That dialogue, I believe, is triggered by picking up the basement key. The lower undead burg is a treacherous place. Do not turn your back on the wily thieves or the wild dogs who serve the Capra demon. But it's also, when I said earlier, I think in, like, episode 2, I talked about how he says, oh, that's all, I need another inquisitive soul. I think maybe he was talking about that sorcerer's apprentice at that point.
What now? I'm not up for chatting. Leave me alone.
I think I accidentally missed the dialogue there somehow. Lautrex here, don't worry. Normally, guys, this is where you would want to do forward R1 and just kick this son of a gun right off here and then quit and load your game and get your Ring of Favor, because the Ring of Favor is a really good ring, but we're not going to do that. Instead, we're going to keep Lautrex alive and we're going to pursue some stuff that we can, some kind of rare dialogues from him.
Ah, hello there. I have your reward. Please accept it.
He gives you a sunlight medal. A lot of people have interpreted this to mean that he is a Sunbro, a member of the Warriors of Sunlight Covenant. He is absolutely not. This has a bit of a darker meaning once you realize that. Seems like he's either received it from someone who was trying to befriend him, or maybe he killed someone and took it. But he is not a member of the Sunlight Covenant, and I will give you conclusive proof of that as we proceed.
I am grateful to you for freeing me. Not enough for you? Well, let's not be greedy now.
Interesting that he gives you something that has absolutely no value to him. A badge of the ultimate honor. This faintly warm metal engraved with the symbol of the sun is the ultimate honor, awarded to those who summon the Warrior of Sunlight and complete a goal. The symbol represents Lord Gwyn's firstborn, who lost his deity status and was expunged from the annals, but the old god of war still watches closely over his warriors. The old god of war still watches closely over his warriors is a line that a lot of people have taken to mean that the firstborn is still in the game. And, you know, it's confirmation there that the firstborn was the god of war. Intriguing, intriguing. We have this Firekeeper soul. I should mention that what does it say? Her soul is gnawed by infinite humanity. Okay, this isn't the one. This is a soul of a long-lost Firekeeper. This is kind of a signal that this is a keeper that doesn't actually exist as an NPC in the game. Anastasia is also a keeper, but her soul has a different description. It's not long lost. But we can use this to reinforce our Estus flask. And once again, reminder that an emerald flask from the Keeper's Soul, they're basically made from the souls of Firekeepers, and that's why you can use their souls to reinforce the flask. Interesting that so many undead, like every generic undead that you encounter, has an Estus flask, though all of the Hollows have Estus flasks that can still heal them. That power continues even after they've gone hollow and lost their mind, lost their purpose, lost their will. But how many Firekeepers did there used to be is kind of the question I would ask, because Estus flasks, an undead favorite, are kind of common. They really are kind of common. Mm-hmm. What? Yeah, I was expecting him to comment on Anastasia, but he has decided not to, which I can do about it. So just continue on. Whoa. I couldn't quite see him there. I was expecting the fast jump, but obviously not expecting it enough. Oh, in case you're wondering, we're not being staggered because I've got the wolf ring on. That's, once again, the glow that's around me. And that's another, actually, a custom texture that I might end up using, is the one that gets rid of the ring effects. Because I don't really like having those annoying glows around my character. I'd rather just see my armor and stuff. And there is a mod that gets rid of it. Rather, it's just a texture file. In the game files, they have textures for these ring effects. And if you just insert the same name file, but with a blank image of just transparency, then the effect just doesn't show up. All right, let's move a little bit quicker through here because we've already been through this section before. Oh, one thing someone was asking me, I can't remember who it was asking me to talk about how the Drake sword 200 physical damage, and now we've already got our long sword. It's upgraded to +5 and it's already doing 146. So it's already starting to catch up to our Drake sword. It also has additional benefits. We can actually buff it using resin or spells to increase the power of our longsword, whereas the Drake sword cannot be enchanted in those ways. And that's really kind of important, especially early in the game. Wow, that was random. That bolt persisted for a long time to actually hit me. Here's the shortcut to the lower undead burg, but we haven't opened it yet. Don't worry, we will soon. It's amazing how quickly you can run through this game if you're trying to move fast. Not me. Maybe you could be pretty quick. Oh, we can open that door. That's something else we can do. We'll do it later. There's so many different things to do in this game, too. And that's a whole nother part of the community that I forgot to give a shout out earlier. Like, all of the speedrunners who are constantly pushing their skill to get faster and faster at these games. Like Oganom, buddy of mine, who's going to be running it. Summer Games Done Quick. Damn you. Damn you, Hellkite! Damn you! Okay, don't breathe fire at me. Once again, the key goes ahead and it actually just tells you the location. Opens the narrow passage leading below at the far face of the Great Bridge and the Undead Bird. And that's where we are. Actually, Solaire, do you have any dialogue for us? I'm gonna try not to miss dialogue if possible.
Oh, hello there. I will stay behind to gaze at the sun. The sun is a wondrous body, like a magnificent father. If only I could be so grossly incandescent.
That is a sun, bro. That is a sun, bro. Lautrec, not a sun, bro. This guy, total sun, bro. And we will summon them and we will see. Alright, into the Undead Burg. With the wily thieves and the vicious dogs that serve the Capra demon. Go ahead and open up our shortcut here. I was wondering where all these guys were at. Come on then. I knew he was gonna do that shit. Of course he's going to use the one move that's going to trade with me. See, look at that. Look at that. Estus Flask. Even the hollows can use it. We're looking pretty hollowed ourselves, but still tastes good. I actually have an Estus Flask, by the way. I know that's kind of a random thought, but I actually have an honest-to-God Estus Flask. It was given to me by Miyazaki-san himself at Fromsoft. I'm sorry, just a little bit of bragging here. I actually have one. It was from the Dark Souls 2 opening. They had made some Estus flasks for a limited time cafe that they had to kind of like help hype up the opening. It was a Dark Souls themed cafe, and they had Estus flasks there, and I got one. They had a couple left, and he said, yeah, you can have this. I'm trying to think. Yeah, let's go ahead and take out the thief ambush first. Oh, wait. Right here. that one. That one. And this guy. By the time you get down here, it's going to open up. And there he is. Oof. These guys can backstab. There we go. They can backstab. They can throw knives at you. And they can parry if he'll oblige me. He's not going to oblige me. He's just going to die. Oh, well. Those are hollow thieves, and you can get confirmation of that from their armor set, which is unfortunately a very rare drop. And I say unfortunately because the set itself actually looks pretty cool. Let me check these houses. Nope, no drops. That sucks. The Mailbreaker, I still maintain that it's pretty much the most useless damn weapon in the game. Yeah, it's got a cool parry animation, but don't think it's actually any faster than the normal one. It does look cool. Mostly, actually, it may be entirely thrusting attacks, if I remember right. Let's see. Yeah, entirely thrusting attacks. Unsharpened but solid, pointed solid shaft can pierce tough armor. Very effective for critical attacks. But there's dogs down here, so. Come on, dogs. Oh, I accidentally triggered the ambush. There's one dog down. Fun to use, though. It is pretty stylish to... Oh, man, I knew that was gonna happen. I was just fucking... I was just stuck there. Well, that was a really glitchy animation, too. I was just fucking stuck, man. Wasn't much I could do. Those glowing red eyes of the hollow thieves. Ooh! Had all three of them. Still no drop, though. That might actually be the first time I've ever actually used a Mailbreaker in a playthrough. Like, I always talk about how I use them. I keep them in my inventory so that I can keep count of which new game cycle I'm on. Because you can only get the one per game, but... I don't think I've ever actually used it before. Not on camera, anyway. Target, man, probably because I normally pick up the target shield immediately thereafter, and this thing is good. Small round metal shield, four protrusions used to parry attacks. Small shields are always less stable, but landing critical hits after parry is easier. This shield is specialized for parrying. Don't pay any attention to the landing critical hits after parry is easier part. That's bullcrap. But it does have a specialized parry timing. It has a longer window than many other shields do. Notice it is heavier than the wooden shield. In fact, it's the same weight as the heater shield. Just interesting. Oh, right. I also got my thief set, which is my beloved thief mask. I love this thing. Mask of sinners. They hide their faces, stifle their voices, and hide in the shadows. It does not provide much in the way of defense, but it does look very cool. The male and female versions of this are actually different. The female version, if I recall correctly, does not have the hood. And that's one of the few armors that's kind of significantly different between the sexes. Oh, I can actually fast roll that, which is the main reason why I always end up using it, I believe. Let's see. I could go to black leather boots. They're slightly lighter. Looks cool with my custom armor set. Looks pretty cool. I'm just seeing what I can fast roll with. Can I equip the thief mask and still fast roll? Ooh, yes. Well, we got our set there, didn't we? We got our set there, didn't we? This is such an old school playthrough. I'm using all of my old favorite equipment. Although I am going to mix it up pretty soon. I'm going to do some off-camera farming to power up some other weapons. Just so that we can have some fun.
Somebody! Please let me out of here. Somebody! Anybody! Help me! Unlock the door!
Damn, I'm finished. How did this ever happen?
You have to have the residence key for that. The master key will not work. This is one of the few doors that's like that. Maybe the only door. Can't remember right now.
Brilliant. You opened the door for me. Thank you. I'm saved. I thought I might never escape. I am Griggs of Vinheim, a sorcerer of the school. I am much obliged for your assistance. Thanks to you, I may now resume my travels. Oh, hello. I'm fine. I will rest a while, then return to Firelink Shrine. I have my sorcery. And I will be more cautious next time. Besides, I have an important task at hand.
Griggs of Vinheim. Also locked in here. Corpse. With another sorcerer set. I wonder who is trapping sorcerers in this room. Perhaps the undead thieves? I don't know why they would be bothering. I don't know. It's really, that's always been a curious point as to what the logic behind that is. But we do have the sorcerer's hat worn by proper sorcerers who studied at Vinheim Dragon School, because there are some sorcerers who did not study at Vinheim Dragon School. We've actually already met one, Beatrice the Witch. She was not of the Dragon School. The majority take pride in having studied at the academy and look down on breaking the formal dress code established for sorcerers. And one more thing here before we wrap up for today. Come on. Come on, ambush. These torch hollows don't fucking play, so I do wish to be careful. These attacks obviously do both physical and fire damage. Come on. Aw. That attack is very dangerous. Ooh, that was slick. That was slick. Come on, guys. You gotta admit that one was slick. That parry. Not exactly the easiest attack to parry, although I'm not ballsy enough to try to do it in a group. Wait, hold on. I haven't used any... Do I have any throwing knives? I do. No. Yeah, there we go. Ha! See, I missed it there, but it went... He actually went straight through me with it. That's why I was saying it's not exactly the easiest attack to parry. Not only because of the timing, but also because of the way the hitbox works. Delicious. Alright, this was the last thing I wanted to point out. This is, once again, Illusory Wall, documenting all of the female corpses in the game. This is one of the very few, maybe perhaps the only one, I can't remember, that isn't a Firekeeper soul corpse. Carries a twin humanities. Rare tiny black sprout found on corpses. Very unusual twin humanity. Really the only difference is the fact that it's a very unusual to find the two of them together. And it just kind of reinforces this notion that females are somehow more human or more prone to draw humanity. Because this one had two, and we saw earlier that the Firekeeper souls themselves act as a draw for humanity. So it's just really intriguing stuff. We will continue on. We're actually gonna end up killing Capra here, or trying to kill Capra here, because we can get some unique dialogues by doing that and doing things in a little bit different order than normal. Because normally you would want to go and kill the gargoyles and do all that hoobajoo first, but first, we gotta deal with this fella. Guys, my name is Marcus. This has been From the Dark. I will catch you guys next time. Later. Alright, the thing. Don't worry. I'm gonna do the thing. You ready? Here we go.